Mercury, the focal element for our research group, is released to the environment from the burning of coal and from gold mining. Mercury pollution itself is not directly dangerous to human health, but it's because it's released into the environment and then transported all over the Earth that it is a global pollutant. And so that being the case, it ends up being transferred in its inorganic form to regions that are not polluted in any way, and then ends up in aquatic systems where it gets biomagnified in the food chain up to fish and other organisms that humans and wildlife eat. The history behind the Dragonfly Mercury project was that it started with one of my colleagues up at the University of Maine. She started a high school program for Dragonfly Mercury. In other words, it was a program that was used to teach high school students about environmental fate of a very ubiquitous pollutant. Our Dartmouth Toxic Metals Superfund research program, which we've had at Dartmouth for many years, took it on as a project to work in our schools in New Hampshire and Vermont. Later, this Dragonfly Mercury project then was adapted to a program that was adopted by the National Park Service and by the U.S. Geological Survey to be implemented as a citizen science project in the national parks. But to run it as a citizen science project and be able to get bigger geographic coverage, dragonflies are a perfect organism. They're perfect because they also bioaccumulate mercury, and specifically methylmercury, which is the toxic form, to a high degree, like fish. The use of the dragonfly is much easier because it's an invertebrate. You don't need lots of state and institutional permits to be able to collect them and measure mercury in them. And it's also a very good bioindicator species because they are found in all kinds of freshwater ecosystems. I think for those of us who are involved in the Dragonfly Mercury project, the hope is that we will be able to expand the number of sites that these citizen science endeavors are being done, and also to be able to continuously sample the sites that have been sampled through time. It's an important possible way for us to determine whether national and international policies on controlling mercury pollution on their effectiveness. In other words, you want to know whether by reducing the amount of mercury going into the environment, you want to know whether it's actually showing up in biotic endpoints. The dragonfly, as a biosentinel or bioindicator, it may be a very useful method for determining change across the landscape as well as change through time.